Welcome back, students. This is the seventh lecture on the chapter of interference. In the previous lecture, we had done an important derivation for the conditions for maxima and minima in a parallel thin film due to reflected light. And if you remember, this was the values which were the conditions which were obtained for maxima and for minima. 2 mu t cos r is equal to 2 n plus 1 lambda by 2 was the condition for maxima, and 2 mu t cos r is equal to n lambda was the condition for minima in a parallel thin film due to reflected light. So we had considered here the reflected rays R1 and R2 for our derivation. We had analyzed them, we had found the path difference between them, and then based on that we had calculated the maxima and minima condition. Now similar derivation has to be done for transmitted light. Now this derivation I won't be doing it fully over here, it's as an assignment for you all to do, but I'll just be starting the initial equations I'll be starting for you all. You can then proceed in this very similar fashion as the previous derivation which we had done for reflected light and obtain a similar derivation for transmitted light. Now when we do for transmitted light, we have to consider the rays T1 and T2. Okay? We have to analyze, we have to find the path difference between the rays T1 and T2 because these are called the transmitted rays. So the same way which the way we had done for R1, R2, the path difference between them, we have to find the path difference between the rays T1 and T2 this time. And proceed further in exactly the same manner, trigonometric formulas you have to use, trigonometric ratio sine, first we start with cos r, then sin I, then tan r, all this procedure remains the same. Okay, so I'll just give you the equation 1 and then you can proceed further with the derivation and get the final equations for maximas and minimas. So to find the path difference between the rays T1 and T2, so it will be what? Delta will be path of ray T2 minus path of T1. Okay, because again over here T2 is the ray which travels a greater distance. If you see from the starting point I, that's from where the light starts, I, A, B, and then from B directly T1 is obtained. Whereas for T2, you have to start from I, go to A, then to B, then to C, D, and then the ray T2 comes up. So T2 is travelling a bigger path than the ray T1. So therefore the path is bigger minus smaller. So the path of T2 minus the path of T1. So again over here as in the previous case, since the rays are parallel, to make them to meet we have to put a lens over here in this path. So once you put a lens, the rays are going to get converged, let us say at this point P over here. So the aim of the derivation is to find out whether at point P there is going to be a maxima or a minima, bright spot or a dark spot, constructive interference or destructive interference. So for that, I have to find the path difference between the rays T1 and T2. So that's what we have written there, path of T2 minus path of T1. So let's trace the path of T2. Path of T2, we have to start from the starting point I. So it will be IA plus AB plus BC plus CD, and then from D to point P will write it as a single thing there, from D, P. Okay, so this is the path of the ray T2. What about the path of the ray T1? So this thing is the path of the ray T2 minus the path of the ray T1. T1 will be starting from point I again, IA plus AB and then from B, let's write BG, and then from G to P. So this is the path of the ray T1. Now you have to subtract them. If you see IA is common in both the places, it will go, AB also will go, and what we will get is finally, now also if you see the distance DP, distance D to P, and the distance from G to P, they are both equal. They are, as per the geometry of the figure, they are both equal in the value. So DP and GP will also cancel out. And you will only get the value as equal to BC plus CD minus BG. So this will be your equation 1. One more thing, since the ray BC and CD are inside the film of refractive index mu, and since we are calculating optical path here, this T thing will be multiplied with mu. The distance BC and CD has to be multiplied with mu, whereas BG is outside the film. If you look in the figure, the distance BG is outside the film. So this will be equal to mu times BC plus CD, and BG, the distance BG here, the range BG is outside the film. So the refractive index there is 1. So there is no mu multiplied for BG. So this will be your equation number 1. And based on this equation, you have to proceed further. Now one more thing you need to keep note of is that there is no lambda by 2 factor coming there. If you see for reflected light, there was an additional factor plus lambda by 2 which had arise because of reflection from a denser surface. Here that additional factor lambda by 2 will not come. Why? Because these both T1 and T2 are transmitted rays. Transmitted rays, there is no extra phase or extra path of lambda by 2 which is introduced. It's only in the reflected ray that the additional path is introduced, and that too reflection from a denser medium. So therefore, when we did reflected rays, that lambda by 2 factor was there. Here, there is no additional factor of lambda by 2. That's the only change, only difference between transmitted light derivation and the reflected light derivation. So, rest all things, you can proceed as per the previous reflected light derivation and obtain the final thing. If you guess it properly, since only the factor lambda by 2 is not present over here, the final expressions for path difference between the rays T1 and T2, final expression for delta will be just 2 mu t cos r. The additional factor minus lambda by 2 which was there for reflected light will not be there over here. So that's the only difference between the two derivations. So all you have to do is now work out using all the different trigonometric ratios which we had used previously. Work out the derivation and see you get the value of delta SS. Okay. Now once you get the value of delta, so all you have to do is put the value of delta as n lambda for constructive interference for maxima, and put the value of delta as 2n plus 1 lambda by 2 for destructive interference minima. So, and that will give you the conditions for maxima and minima. So what will be the condition for maxima? If you work it out, we'll get condition for maxima will be 2 mu t cos r, 2 mu t cos r, you work it out and see, is equal to n lambda. This will be the condition for maxima in transmitted light, and 2 mu t cos r is equal to 2n plus 1 lambda by 2. This will be the condition for minima in transmitted light. Why? Because here the additional factor lambda by 2 is not there. So directly we will get the conditions for maxima as 2 mu t cos r is equal to n lambda, and 2 mu t cos r is equal to 2n plus 1 lambda by 2 will be the condition for minima. Okay. If now you just compare this with what we had obtained for reflected light conditions for maxima and minima, if you see reflected light the conditions are 2 mu t cos r is equal to 2n plus 1 lambda by 2 was the condition for maxima, and here minima condition was 2 mu t cos r is equal to n lambda. So please note 2n plus 1 lambda by 2 is maxima for reflected light, whereas for transmitted light 2 mu t cos 2n plus 1 lambda by 2 becomes the condition for minima. So they're just opposite or the reverse of each other. So what you can understand from this is that, and we'll just write it as a summary so that we can have it in one single place here, both the formulas. So for reflected light, in parallel thin film due to reflected light, the condition for maxima is 2 mu t cos r is equal to 2n plus 1 lambda by 2. This is the condition for maxima. And 2 mu t cos r is equal to n lambda. This was the condition for minima in reflected light. And for transmitted light, the conditions for maxima and minima are 2 mu t cos r is equal to n lambda. This is the condition for maxima. And 2 mu t cos r is equal to 2n plus 1 lambda by 2. This was the condition for minima. Now if you compare these two, you will see that what the maxima condition is here, it becomes a minima condition in transmitted light. And what is the minima condition in reflected light becomes the maxima condition in transmitted light. So we can see that the conditions are opposite of each other. So what is the physical significance of this? What do we imply from this? Maxima means bright spot, minima means dark spot, right? So what it means is that what point appears as bright in reflected light system, reflected rays, the same point will appear as a dark spot in transmitted light. So what appears as bright in reflected appears as dark in transmitted, and vice versa. What appears as dark in reflected will appear as bright in transmitted. So this is what we call as complementarity. The interference pattern produced in reflected light and transmitted light are complementary to each other. So the interference pattern due to reflected light and transmitted light are complementary. The important word is complementary. Okay. So, what is the meaning of complementary? Black complementary color is white. So similarly, bright complementary is dark. Okay. So in reflected light, what is bright becomes dark in transmitted, and vice versa. So we say that reflected and transmitted light interference patterns are complementary to each other. So with this we finish with the interference in a parallel thin film. Remember, I have not done an entire derivation for transmitted light. It is as an assignment for you all to do. So reflected light and transmitted light, both we have done. Now we are going to now proceed with the second type of interference film, that is interference in a wedge shaped film. Okay, so we are going to do three types of films basically. Parallel film, which is the simplest film, upper surface and lower surface, the thickness remains same. Next type of film will be a wedge shaped film, and the third type will be a circular film, which will give rise to what is called as Newton's rings. Okay, so that I will do in the next class.